our third instrument in the micrometer family, which is basically known as a depth micrometer. So depth micrometer, as the name suggests, it is used for measurement of depth dimensions. Depth micrometer basically have a base like this. This is the base of this depth micrometer, and above this base it is having the micrometer head. Micrometer head means what? A barrel tube, a thimble and a ratchet screw. So this comes with the sticks to measurement of sticks for measurement of depth dimensions. What it do have is it have a thimble, and with this thimble a small portion is cut, which is known as a thimble cap. So you have to rotate this thimble cap, it will get disengaged like this, and you have to insert a stick inside this. So when you insert a stick, the stick will come out and the stick will behave as a spindle. So with this stick, you have to insert the stick inside the component for which the measurement is to be taken, and you have to rotate this thimble. And you have to rotate this thimble till the stick touches the reference surface. So that is how the measurement should be taken with help of a depth micrometer. Now in case of our micrometer, what we do have is we have sticks. We have 5 sticks with different measurements. The first stick measures dimension from 25 to 50. We don't have a stick which measures 0 to 25. So 25 to 50, 50 to 75, 75 to 100, 100 to 125 and 125 to 50. So total 5 sticks are there. That's why range of this micrometer belongs to 25 to 150. But again, all the sticks are in span of 25. Let us see how to use this micrometer for measurement of depth dimensions. So this is the component. This is basically a gear, and this gear is having a hole, and I want to measure the depth of this hole. So it is basically a through hole like this, and I have kept a gear like this. Now to measure this depth, I am supposed to choose a stick. So you should choose a stick such that it will enter inside this and it will touch the reference face. So out of this, we know the basic dimension of this. That's why I will choose a stick which belongs to this, that is 25, 50, 50, 75, 75 to 100. So I will take this stick, and initially it will be in a position like this. I will just open this, I will insert the stick over here, and I will just lock it into position once again. So I will bring it to initial position. Now initial position here, the reading of outside micrometer, that is graduation of this depth micrometer and inside micrometer, they are basically same. Here also it starts with 0, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, likewise up to 25. And the circular scale is also is having a similar graduation as that of inside micrometer. Only inside micrometer and depth micrometer should be reading same fashion. Just now we have seen how to read inside micrometer. This should be also reading the same fashion, because initially when you keep a depth micrometer in this position like this, now if I rotate the thimble, so this thimble will start covering the reading in this direction. So I have to rotate this. Once it touches to the face of surface plate, you can identify the touch by using this ratchet. So when I rotate the ratchet and when it touches, it will click. So once it clicks, you have to lock this knob into position. After locking the knob, you have to take this micrometer outside, and then you have to start reading this. As I mentioned, this should be read in the same way as that of inside micrometer. So just observe the scales here. This is 20, okay, and this is 19, 18, this is 17, 16.5 is visible over here. So the division which has been covered is 16. So my main scale reading will be 16, and the line which is either matching or which is above this baseline. So division number 15 is above this. So 15 is my circular scale reading. So according to this, main scale reading is 16 mm, circular scale is 15 into not 1, that is 0.15. So 16.15 is the reading at this. But you have to remember that though the reading is 16.15, what has happened is we have put the stick of 75 to 100 in this particular micrometer. So we have put a stick of 75 to 100 inside the micrometer. That's why when you are taking reading to this 16.15, you have to add the first dimension of the stick, that is 75 to 100. That means I will add 75 to this dimension. So final reading is 75 plus 16.15. Therefore, the reading is 91.15 mm.